guys, what is up? Welcome back to a brand new video. Now in this video, I'll be starting a highly requested video series where I will be teaching you how to make your very own simulator game on Roblox. Now as you may know, a lot of different simulator games have different game mechanics, so I can't cover all of those in a single tutorial. So I'm going to be making a basic simulator tutorial in these videos, something based around the concept of weightlifting simulator. You've probably heard about it before, and that's what we're going to be doing in this video series. So in this first part, we will be covering how to make a tool that gives you points and how to make a leaderboard that saves the points for every player. So what we're going to have as a tool is weights so that the player can lift them to earn points or strength. So I'm just going to build a weight. So you can just use the normal Roblox parts to build these. I'm just going to build something very simple. Okay, so these are the weights that I built for the player. So we're just going to go ahead and go to model and click union to make it a single part. So now that we have this single part, you can go ahead into workspace, click this plus button and type in tool. So now we're going to place this into the tool and we're going to have to name this handle. So this is the part that the player grabs in his hand. So we're going to click tool and rename this to weight. And we can resize this to a smaller scale. So now that we have this, we're going to go ahead and put it in the starter pack. Now that we have it in the starter pack, that means that the player will spawn with the weight in his backpack. So if we go ahead and click play, you can see that now the player can equip the weight in his hands and put it in his hands, but we can't use it yet because we need to make the points and the leaderboard. So we're going to stop the game and start making our first script. This is going to go inside the server script service. And by the way, if you don't have this explorer window, all you have to do is click view and explorer over here and make sure you have your properties window open, which will be in the side. This is the properties window. So we're going to into server script service, right click, insert object and script. So now we're going to name this script points management. You can name it whatever you want, but this seems like a relevant name to give it. So we're going to start off by addressing the data store service. So we're just going to do local data store equals game colon get service data store service. So I do have a tutorial on how to make a leaderboard with saving points. So if you think this is complicated for you, make sure you check out the other tutorial. But if you just want to make a simulator, you can just follow through. So now we're going to do local points data equals data store colon get ordered data store like this. Make sure it has the same caps on each word, just like that. It has the brackets over here. And we're going to name this points. Okay. So now we're going to make it so that whenever a player enters the game, so we're going to do game.players.playerAdded colon connect and brackets like these, which says PLR, and click enter, and it will add this piece right here at the end. So we're going to address the player. So the player is PLR. So we're going to give him the player's points. So we're going to do local points equals points data colon get async PLR dot user ID. So now we're going to place these points inside the leaderboard. So Roblox has a built-in leaderboard that we can use. So to do this, we're going to do local leader stats equals instance.new folder. So you have to write this exactly like this. And now we're going to give this folder a name. We're going to name this leader stats. Make sure you name it exactly like this or else Roblox won't find it. So now we're going to place the points value inside of the leaderboard. So we're going to do local points value equals instance.new int value comma leader stats. So we're going to make a value and we're going to place it inside the leaderboard, which we called leader stats. So now we're going to give this value of the points. So we're going to, we've already loaded the points over here, so we're just going to do points value dot value equals points. So now we have this whole script right here. So if you go ahead and go back into the tutorial part and we click play. Actually, I forgot something else that you need to put. So you need to go ahead and click enter to put a new line and put leaderstats.parent equals PLR so that the points and the leaderboard are stored inside the player. So now we're going to go back and click play so we can test the leaderboard. So as you can see here, it says value and we have 0 points. So now instead of value, we can give it a name. So now instead of zero, we can give the value a specific name. So let's name this strength. So we're going to stop the game, go back into our script and put points value dot name equals strength. So now we have our leaderboard done. So we're going to go back into our weight right here and insert object and put a script. Make sure you put this script. We're going to right click again and we're going to put a local script. One last thing is we're going to right click, insert object for the last time, and you're going to put a remote event. So we're going to name this lift weight. So whenever he lifts the weight, this is going to be triggered. So we're going to into this local script, we're going to name this main script, and we're going to start by defining the weight. So local weight equals script.parent weight.activated :connect open brackets function open brackets close brackets. There we go. So whenever the weight has been activated, the player is going to lift the weight and gain strength. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do if weight.parent is exactly equal to game.players.localplayer.character, then, so what this does is it checks if the weight is in the player's hand. So if it's in the player's hand, he can lift the weight. So we're going to do script.parent.liftweight :fireserver. So it's going to request the server to give points to the player for lifting the weight every time he clicks. So now we can close that script. We're going to get into this script right here. So we have it open right here. We're going to name this strength. And we're going to do script.parent.liftweight.onServerEvent :connect open brackets function open brackets close brackets. And inside here, we're going to type in local strength. So we're going to find the strength value of the player. So local strength equals game.players and square brackets, and we're going to put this inside. So we're going to do script.parent.parent.name dot leader stats dot strength. Now we're going to do strength.value equals strength.value plus 1. So every time the player lifts the weight, you're going to get 1 strength. So if you want us to give more strength, we can do 3 or 5. So now if we run the script, so since it's 5 over here, he's going to gain 5 strength. So if we click back on the tutorial and click play, we have the weight. And every time he clicks, he gets more strength, as you can see. I'm clicking every time and he's gaining strength. So as we said before, since we wrote plus 5 in here, every time he clicks, he's going to get 5 strength. So if we made this number 1 instead of 5, he gets 5 strength every click. So as you can see, he doesn't really show that he's lifting his weights when we click, because that is something called animation. And we're not going to cover that in today's video, maybe later in another video. But for today, it's just lifting weights. So we're going to stop this and we're going to do the last thing for today's video. Going back into this script, the points management script, and we're going to make it save for the player. So we're going to start a new line and we're going to do game.players.playerRemoving :connect open brackets function open brackets PLR. So now when the player is removed from the game, that means he left the game. So we're going to find the strength value of that player. So we're going to do local strength equals PLR dot leader stats dot strength dot value. So now we're going to do points data colon set async. So here we use the get async, which means they're going to load the data, and we're going to use set async, it means it's going to save the data. So we're going to do plr.userid. Make sure the I is capital, just like that. And we're going to do strength. So it's going to save the strength for the player. And we're going to do print saved data. So it shows that it saved the data. So before making your game save, you need to enable it from your settings. So we're going to go over to our game by clicking create. And finding your game from here, go to this configure icon and click configure game. And you're going to click enable studio access to API services. We're just going to check that and click save. So now this allows us to save our game inside of Roblox Studio. So now if you go back into the game and we're going to click play so we can test this saving feature. We're going to equip our weights, and as you can see, when we click, we're going to get strength. Now to make our player leave the game in studio, we're going to click here and go to players and click on your player and click delete on your keyboard. Now it says saved data right here. That means your data has been successfully saved. And now if you stop the game from testing and we rejoin the gameplay by clicking play, you can see our data has been saved and we have the strength that we last had in the last server. So that is all we're going to be covering today in this video tutorial. Make sure you stay tuned for part 2, where I show you how to make a shop and how to make upgrades for your weights so there could be better weights than this one, so that your players can have fun and buy different weights. So make sure to stay tuned for that. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and like this video if you thought it was helpful. Otherwise, I'll see you guys later. Peace.